Lord, Sesi Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila Prabhupada, all glories to the assembled devotees, glories to the assembled devotees, glories to Sri Guru and Shivananda. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. So, this is the fourth and the last in a series of lectures on Vaishnav culture, Vaishnav service, Vaishnav association. So I thought I'd end a little bit with a different aspect, but I think also a most important aspect. We were talking about what we should do in the association of Vaishnavas, how we should develop a mood of friendship, a mood of service, a mood of sacrifice. So I thought now we would talk about what you shouldn't do. Is that all right? Usually you end up with what you should do, but since we did three shoulds, You heard that? Okay, so this is what you shouldn't do, and then after a while you say, I shouldn't have did this, I could have did something different, I would have did something different, but I didn't. So this is what we should not do. And it's also part of the purification process. Because Vaishnava culture and Vaishnava philosophy, and let's say Vaishnava protocol, is that there's things that you must do and there's things you must carefully avoid. Because in not avoiding those things which are avoidable or must be avoided, we minimize the results and the benefit of what we actually do that is right. In fact, and sometimes we even destroy it. To create something is easy. It's easy to create something, and it's very easy to destroy something. Brahma is the creator, Shiva is the destroyer. But who's the maintainer? So to maintain is really the key to what we say, bringing what we create to the platform of perfection. Just like this center, Ananda Gopal, he was the initiator. So for him to create it, it's not so hard. Anybody can create a center. To maintain it, that's the tough part. And to destroy it, it's easy. So destruction and creation come by way of something that is pretty much the feature of the material world. Things are created, things are destroyed. But maintaining is in the mood of goodness. The maintaining is the culture of Vaishnav success, to maintain what we develop and not allow anything to destroy it. And the example is that if you create a wonderful garden and you have so many flowers and fruits and trees and shrubbery, and you want to keep it and then make it even better. But if an elephant or a wild animal comes in, then whatever you've created is lost. So, therefore, we should very carefully avoid certain things in devotional service. So we'll talk about that tonight. So here's a verse from the Chaitanya Charitamrita. It's in Adi Lila, chapter number 8. And so Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami entitles the chapter, the author, talking about himself, receives the orders of Krishna. And okay. So I'll read. I think we can do the Bengali together because it's really nice. Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavrinda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavrinda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Jaya Sri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavrinda
Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaur Bhaktavrinda
So, let's see if we can do this verse together. Vaishnavera Guna Grahi
Vaishnavera Guna Grahi
Nadekaya dosha.
Nadekaya dosha.
Okay, let's. Vaishnavera guna grahi nadekaya dosha. Jaya jaya sri chaitanya jaya. Vaishnavera guna grahi nadekaya dosha.
Vaishnavera guna grahi nadekaya dosha.
Vaishnavera guna grahi nadekaya dosha.
Vaishnava
Kaimano Vaishnava Santosa Koimano Vakekari Vaishnava Santosa
Vaishnava
Santosa Vaishnava Guna Dosa
Vaishnavera
guna grahi naya dosha Vaishnava santosa
Vaishnavera
guna grahi naya dosha
Vaishnavera guna grahi naya dosha
Koyamano vakyakara Vaishnava santosa Vaishnavera of devotees,
Gunagrahi,
accepting good qualities,
never,
Dehaye, I'm sorry, Dekaye, sees,
dosa,
any fault.
Koyamana
Vakye with heart and soul. Kare does Vaishnava
devotee
Shantosa pacification. This is referring to one of Lord Chaitanya's associates whose name was Pandit Haridas. It's not Haridas, of course, another Haridas. And it says here, he always accepted the good qualities of Vaishnavas and never found fault. He engaged his heart and soul only in satisfying Vaishnavas. Please repeat, he always accepted the good qualities of Vaishnavas and never found fault in them. He gave his heart and soul, only to satisfy the Vaishnavas.
Only to satisfy the Vaishnavas.
Srila Prabhupada's purport. It is the quality of a Vaishnava that he is a dosha darshan. He never sees others' faults. Of course, every human being has both good qualities and faults. Therefore, it is said, Sajana gunam ichchanti dosha ichchanti paramaha. Everyone has a combination of faults and glories, but a Vaishnava, the sober man, never and only accepts a man's glories And that's false. For flies seek sores where honeybees seek honey. Haridas Panda never found fault with the Vaishnava, considered only his good qualities. Om Gyan Tibidam Dasya Gnajana Salakaya Chaksu Nityanayana Tasmai Shri Guru Vema Shri Chaitanya Manavisham Stavitamena Bhutale Sayurupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Adaita Dada Shri Vasari Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about a particular personality who exemplifies the qualities of a true Vaishnava. A Vaishnava is one who is very intelligent. He's not a fool. Sees things as they are, but learns how to deal with things in such a way that he always brings out the best in everything, and always the best in everyone. And then Prabhupada uses the example. A fly will always go from places that are not very clean. That's the nature of a fly. There's different types of insects. And beings will climb. Some beings go for the nice nectarine fruits, and others go for the sour fruit. Others go for nice palatial, very, what we say, beautiful countryside, and others like to live in the dirty places in the cities. So we see people have different characteristics and qualities. So a honeybee always seeks the honey. Doesn't really eat the honey itself, but it brings the honey for others. That's a honeybee. So devotee, or one who is in that consciousness of practicing devotional service, and one who has achieved the perfection of devotional service, is a little different. But both have a certain similarity, and both do not find fault. One sees faults and one doesn't see faults. One on the highest platform never sees the faults of others, although there may be faults in there. But one on a practicing platform will see the faults of another devotee, but also will see the good qualities. In fact, they'll look for the good qualities. And so it is natural and normal to sometimes recognize something that is not acceptable, or is a bad quality or a fault, or something that is a diversion from proper spiritual consciousness, or even proper material moral principles. But the devotee doesn't want to focus on that. He wants to see what are those good qualities that make up this particular person. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has coined the phrase dosha darshi. And darshi means to see, and dosha means faults. Adosha means without faults. So one who doesn't see the faults in others becomes very dear to Lord Chaitanya. And he actually says that as a statement. One who chants the holy names of the Lord regularly and doesn't find fault with anyone becomes very dear to me. He actually says, I give my complete mercy to that individual. So how is it possible when we have to, when we live in a world that is Kali Yuga, Kalair Dosha Nidhi Rajan, Astiyek, no, that's not the verse. I mean, what is the verse? Alprayeno Sabda Yuge Nijasmin. What is that first word? First canto, first chapter, verse number 10. Prayena alprayesa sabda. Prayena alprayesa sabda. Kolo yuge, kolo yuge jasmin janaha. Manda sumanda mateyo manya bhaga upadritaha. Sutta Goswami says, in this age, people are so full of falsehoods. It's just the nature of the age. It's a very bad age. And people are very much affected. Just like if you go into a diseased area, unless you're very, very, very strong, healthy, you're going to be susceptible to whatever diseases are there. So in the same way, just being in Kali Yuga, faults are everywhere. They're in the atmosphere. They're inside. And then as we associate with the environment, we also have a tendency to be affected by that environment. So sometimes devotees pick up faults, and sometimes whatever faults they have is magnified by the atmosphere of Kali Yuga. This is the nature of this age. But one who's practicing Krishna consciousness knows that a Vaishnava is very dear to Krishna. And Satyaraj Khan was speaking to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Satyaraj Khan was from Kalinagram. In Kalinagram, Lord Chaitanya said, even a dog in Kalinagram is dear to me. Lord Chaitanya had special affection for all the residents of Kalinagram. And then in speaking about the glories, Satyaraj Khan, his father was Gunaraj Khan. Gunaraj Khan wrote a beautiful book on the glories of Krishna's pastimes. Did you ever read that book? It's a beautiful book. It describes Krishna Leela in a way that just charms your mind and heart. It takes Prabhupada's same leelas, and it's highly, Prabhupada actually talks about this book in one of his letters. He says devotees should read this book. It's the essence of the happiness you can achieve from reading Krishna's pastimes. It's all Krishna Leela. And it's many leelas that we don't find in Bhagavatam also. So his son was Satyaraj Khan. And he said to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is a Vaishnava? How can we tell who is a Vaishnava? And you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said a really startling statement. He said, anybody who wants chants the holy name of Krishna, I consider to be a Vaishnava. That's what he said. He gave a very, what we say, liberal statement regarding what actually is a Vaishnava. One who even chants once the holy name of God didn't say anything about his qualities or anything. That was Lord Chaitanya's response. So Lord Chaitanya came to inspire people to chant the holy names. And anyone who chants the holy names of the Lord, God, welcome, becomes very, very dear to Lord Chaitanya. We can explain that one can, Lord Chaitanya, when he sees or hears anyone chanting Hare Krishna, he thinks, oh, this person is a great personality. This is Lord Chaitanya. Although he's the Supreme Lord, and he's always chanting the holy names, he glorifies those who chant the holy name, even less than normal. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So therefore, using this definition, how can we understand this principle? Is that anyone who comes in contact with this movement is considered to be a Mahatma. That is the word that's used by the Acharyas, that it's not ordinary that a person comes to Krishna consciousness. And therefore that person is considered to be Mahatma. Bahunam janamam ante gyanamam mam prapadide vasudeva sarvamimi samahatma sadurlabaha. And the Bhagavad Gita says, after many, many births and deaths, one who is actually acknowledged comes to devotional service. Such a great soul is really there. But to speak about one who practices, even one who comes is considered to be very special. So, therefore, the explanation is that it's very difficult not to see faults in others, but at the same time not to, I'd say, make those faults your vision. In other words, one will just push it aside. Oh, that person has the faults, but he has so many good qualities. So to see faults and good qualities side by side is pretty much normal consciousness. Or normal consciousness in the sense that you can't avoid seeing faults, but at the same time, one should not consider them to be important. Why? Because the Vaishnava is over qualities. Therefore, anyone who comes in contact with this movement is considered to be, as Lord Chaitanya said, a great soul. Now, there's one stage lower than that. I'll start, that's stage two, to see Vaishnavas, to see good qualities, and to see faults. There's one before that, and that is one who sees faults even in a person who has all good qualities. That's the Daksha mentality. The Daksha came into the assembly of great sages. Lord Shiva was sitting there. Lord Shiva was in meditation on the Supreme Lord. Everyone honored Daksha because Daksha was a great soul. But Shiva, in his meditation, didn't honor Daksha. Daksha was his father-in-law. He had married Daksha's daughter, Sati. Daksha became very upset. When one is proud, one expects things from others. Pride causes one to think, I'm better than others. And if one is getting some recognition, and pride develops because of recognition, one becomes accustomed to certain types of, what we say, respects and admirations or whatever, and when it doesn't come, it causes disturbance. So, Daksha, he was a progenitor, he was the son of Lord Brahma. He had all good qualities, but he was proud. And when Shiva didn't stand up and honor Daksha when he came in the assembly, Daksha became very upset and started to find fault with Lord Shiva in so many ways, one fault after another. Now, Shiva is Vaishnava Yadashambhu. He's the best of all Vaishnavas. Although he's unusual, he carries snakes around his shoulders. Sometimes he